The Auditor General's report of 2022-2023 revealed that Posta Uganda, a government-owned institution, is weighed down by debts amounting to 20.4 billion shillings for a long time. Appearing before the Public Accounts Committee yesterday, the management of Posta Uganda asked the government to give them a financial boost of at least 5 billion shillings annually to keep it afloat in business. James Alinaitwe, the Posta Uganda boss, said the agency's business has suffered challenges of the rapidly changing technologies. He cited that people have resorted to electronic mails as opposed to traditional postal letters.
So I've appealed to government on two fronts. Ministry of Finance, can you pay the share capital that you should have paid? 5.5 billion shillings.
Alinaitwe emphasized the crucial role of their services, citing that it's mandatory for every legally registered business in Uganda to own a postal address, yet the entity does not receive enough funding to carry on with operations across the country.
Every business doing work in this country should have an address, P.O. Box. That law is valid. What we did was to digitize the addresses, put them on all platforms, whether it's a telephone, whether it's a mobile phone, or even a computer. So you can apply and acquire an address online.
What angered the legislators, however, was learning that the postal management sold off some agency property. Mbale City councillors yesterday, May 22nd, left furious after the speaker allegedly declined to chair a council meeting. Lunyoro Josephine Flavia, the Minister of Finance, said that the day was scheduled for laying out the budget, which is a crucial element in the planning and financing of the city. However, they were shocked that it didn't take place.
For two terms, this is the third one. I know what is done in what? In the local government. I know what a budget means. And how passing a late budget, it attracts penalty.
Abdallah Magambo, the deputy speaker, said he did not receive an official communication from the speaker instructing him to chair a council meeting.
As the deputy speaker, I'm handcuffed. The law permits that if the deputy speaker, to chair any council sitting, it must receive a notification or a letter from the main speaker. So in this reference, I was supposed to receive a writing that I'm going to chair this council, but my speaker was around.
When contacted, Speaker Mariam Nambuya said that she was unaware of any council meeting and that she retains all powers to invite and convene council meetings. She further said they had time to pass the budget and there is no need to rush.
Issues of the budget, we are still within time. There's nothing like someone has delayed to pass the budget. As we are talking, this is May, and I've told you we have a council on 30th of May, and we have another council on around 26th of June. So issues of passing the budget, we are still within the timeline.
Besides attracting a penalty, the delay to pass the Mbale City Council budget means denying the much needed services to the residents of Mbale City. By press time, the council had not shown any sign of seating. The Uganda Scouts Chief Commissioner, Susan Namarome, urged the Minister of Education and Sports to increase funding towards Scouts and Girl Guides activities. Namarome expressed the need to revive scouting activities across the country, which are being hindered by the low funds. She also asked the government to further its effort in empowering the girl child through funding of girl guide associations. She was speaking during the closure of a three-day training of girl guide leaders in the eastern region.
Majorly, why we came to train is we want to revive the girl guide activities in all regions of Uganda and in all districts, and we have done this to other districts.
Dr. Eunice Katashumba, the national trainer of the Uganda Girl Guide Association, appealed to scouts to champion the fight against corruption and other acts hindering service delivery to the public. Katashumba further emphasized the need for scouting associations to embark on various income-generating activities to guarantee economic self-sustainability.
So when the harvest comes and every guide brings maybe 2, 3, 4 tomatoes and you put them together, can you sell them?
The training and sensitization camp attracted Girl Guide leaders from 17 districts of Greater Eastern Region in Imbale City. The Scouts movement was started in Uganda in 1915 by Robert Baden-Powell in Barra District before it was later spread to other parts of the country.